Hello students, hope you are all well at your homes. So today our next topic for chapter light is image formation by spherical mirrors. The two spherical mirrors that we have to consider is concave mirror and convex mirror that we have studied in the last video also. So for image formation we will consider ray diagrams, how the images are formed with the help of concave and convex mirrors. The ray diagrams are used to learn this, okay. And for drawing these ray diagrams there are some particular rules, okay. So the rules to draw the ray diagrams for image formation by spherical mirrors are as follows, okay. The first rule is when an incident ray or a light ray is falling parallel to the principal axis on any type of mirror. First type of mirror I am considering is a concave mirror, okay. So the incident ray is parallel. For the incident ray which is parallel, this is center of curvature, this is pole, this is C, and this is between that it is F. This thing we have, the parameters we have studied in the last video, okay. So according to that parameters I am writing. And first rule says that whenever any incident ray is parallel to the principal axis, then after reflection it will pass through focus. Definitely it will pass through focus. This is the rule, okay. And these rules have been made with the help of experimental situations, okay. With the help of experiments these rules have been made, okay. So till here also we can draw or we can extend it also. So any incident ray which is coming parallel to the principal axis will pass through the focus after reflection, okay. Now for convex, how it will look like? For convex I told you in the last video also the parameters will be towards the right hand side, that is suppose this is C and this is P and this will be F. So for the case of convex, if the incident ray is parallel to the principal axis, then how does it reflect? It will reflect in the direction of focus, okay. It will not come towards this side because it is a mirror, it cannot pass through the mirror. It will reflect, okay. Reflect means going back, fine. So how it will reflect? It will not reflect like this, it will not reflect like this. It will be reflecting in the direction of focus. So first of all I will draw the direction to show you. This is the direction with the dotted line. I am drawing the direction. So in the direction of focus it will reflect, okay. It can also be said that it appears to pass through focus. It is not passing through focus, it is appearing to pass through focus, okay. Now what is the second rule? Second rule it is just quite opposite to this first rule, we can say. So first of all I will draw this concave mirror so that it is easy to tell you. This is pole P, this is center of curvature, this is focus F, okay. For the second rule it is quite opposite to this. That means whenever any incident ray is coming in the direction of focus, or it is coming or it is passing through focus, suppose this is the incident ray coming from downwards. Incident ray coming from downwards and it is passing through focus, then after reflection it will become parallel to the principal axis. It will become parallel to the principal axis. These arrows are very very important, let me tell you over here, okay. Because arrows are showing the incident ray and the reflected ray, okay. Incident ray here in this direction coming towards the mirror, and going away from the mirror is joined by reflected ray. Here incident ray is this one coming towards the mirror, and then after reflection it is going away from the mirror. Fine. This incident ray can be coming from here also, like this. If the mirror is like this, okay, so this incident ray can be shown as like this, coming from the upside incident ray, then after reflection it will become parallel to the principal axis. Fine. So this is the rule. Fine. If this rule is applicable to convex, then how will I draw for convex? In convex it will always be appear to pass through, it will not be passing through, so it will be appear to pass through. If any incident ray appear to pass through focus, okay, or it is coming in the direction of focus, in the direction of focus is like this, this is the direction. If it is coming in the direction of focus, then after reflection it will become parallel. Okay, so it can come from here also, like this. Fine. So this is the second rule. And now what is the third rule? In third rule, it is very very simple rule for concave mirror. The third rule says, so third rule is, when we pass any incident ray through the center of curvature, if we consider any incident ray which is passing through center of curvature, okay, this is incident ray, then it will follow the same path after reflection. Okay, the same path will be followed after reflection. Okay, in the case of convex, how it can be drawn? It can be said that because the center of curvature C is over here, so if the incident ray is in the direction of center of curvature, suppose this is the direction of center of curvature, this, then it will follow the same path after reflection. Now why is it so? Why this rule? There is some specific reason that we can understand over here. Because center of curvature and the line joining the center of curvature and any part of the mirror, whether it is pole, whether it is this point or this point or this point, because it was sphere in the beginning, we have understood it, this was this mirror is has been cut from a hollow sphere. Okay, so because it was whole hollow sphere, so it was the center of that sphere, then this is the radius and this is also the radius, then this is also the radius for that whole sphere. So what this line will be, this line which is joining center of curvature and any one point on the mirror will become the radius, and all the radiuses are always perpendicular to the point at which we are considering, at me this point. This is perpendicular, this is also perpendicular, and this, if it is this point, if it is this point, so all the radiuses are perpendicular to the point on the circle or the sphere. So here also this line is perpendicular, or we can say it is normal. And if any incident ray is in the direction of normal, then it will form a angle of incidence 0 degree. Okay, and then angle of reflection will also be 0 degree. So that is why it is following the same path after reflection. Fine. Now what is the fourth rule? Fourth rule is also very very simple. It is according to the laws of reflection. So first of all, I am drawing over here concave mirror. This is F, this is C, this is F, this is P. Okay, if any incident ray is making some angle at pole, suppose angle is angle of incidence I, Then after reflection, it will follow the laws of deflection and making the same angle, angle R, equal angle. Okay, and this will be for convex. This is F, this is C, this is P. So at P, if any incident ray is coming, then after reflection, it will follow the laws of reflection. It will follow the, it will be making the same angle. Okay. So these are the four rules according to which the image formation ray diagrams we will draw. Let us quickly revise. What is the first rule? First rule says that whenever any incident ray is parallel to the principal axis, then after reflection it will pass through focus. Here after reflection it will pass through, it will appear to pass through focus, or it will be reflected as in the direction of focus. Aise bhi keh sakte hain. Theek hai. What is the second rule? It is just opposite to the first rule, that if any incident ray is passing through focus, then after reflection it will become parallel to the principal axis. Okay, here also in convex it is happening. If any incident ray coming in the direction of focus, then after reflection it will become parallel. What is the third rule? Third rule says that if any incident ray is passing through center of curvature, then after reflection it will follow the same path. Here also in convex mirror we will define it like this, that if any incident ray is coming towards the in the direction of the center of curvature, then after reflection it will follow the same path. What is the fourth rule? If any incident ray is coming towards the mirror and it is falling on, it is incident on the pole making an angle I, then after reflection it will pass through, it will reflect with the angle of reflection R, which is equal to angle of incidence I. Okay, now here also if any incident ray is making an angle I at pole, then after reflection it will be reflecting with the angle equal to I. Okay, that means I should be equal to R. So these are the rules which we will be following for the image formation of concave mirror and convex mirror. Okay, hope you understood all these rules. These are very very important rules to draw the ray diagrams. So please remember these rules so that it will become easy to remember the image formation ray diagrams. Okay, thank you so much.